Hello, my beautiful art community. Thank you so much for tuning into my channel today. Today I'm going to be starting a new painting. Yes, I am. I'm going to be starting a new painting. Thank you for joining me in this experience I'm going to be sharing with you. Primarily going to be taking a sort of a, I don't know if you've noticed this before, but I primarily work in neutral tones and I try to extend that as much as I can within the realm of being still neutral. So let's just give it a go and let's see where it happens.
So as you can see, I got a head start and I had already started the painting. I am pretty much just going in and trying to figure out those values within the composition and moving them wherever I believe my observation leads to. You sort of have to develop this obsession with observing things. When you look at certain things within whatever it may be that's around you, your surroundings, you need to really, 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 really look. And that goes for not just life, but also within the reference photo that you're looking at. It's kind of a new trend that I'm doing where I just use a set of colors, and with this piece and with the prior piece that I had worked on, I had just pretty much narrowed it down to cadmium yellow and also violet. So I pretty much just took those two colors, and of course I'm sure that you know with our previous video I talked about how they are vibrating colors. They are also complementary colors. Yes, if you look on that color wheel, violet, yellow, completely opposite sides of that dank color wheel. So you'll see that they actually work really well together. You might be watching this and thinking, Candace, this looks nothing like you. What are you even doing? Well, I'll tell you what I'm doing, honey. I'll tell you what I am doing right now.
I don't know why, but for some reason, I feel like I sounded like a cat right there. I'll tell you what I'm doing right meow.
Tell you what I'm doing. I'll tell you what I'm doing right. Okay, but in all seriousness, I will tell you what I am doing. From my perspective, I feel like almost it's like I need to get my foot in the door. I need to at least get my foot in that door in order to run to the finish line. And if I don't have that in the door, I'm not gonna be willing to continue with the piece. So I wanna be able to get that gesture down that I'm observing in my reference photo. I wanna be able to get that basic understanding of the shape of the piece. But as we know, I am a big fan of atmospheric perspective and sort of tying that back into my portraiture. Well, I am blocking in a good majority of the canvas with the violet. So I guess what I'm really trying to say is that I am just trying to get as much done as quickly as I can. Because, you know, I just don't want to be too attached to the results right now. That's not my goal. My goal is not to get fixated on the result. Try to think about it like this. When you want to cook a very nice meal, let's say, you're still going to have that in your mind. Like, you're still going to want to get to that part where you have that nice meal, right? But if you become so overwhelmed by that idea and that goal, it's going to take apart. Well, it's really going to just take you away from now. It's going to take you away from that process. So you just got to put that pan down on the stove, put that butter on that pan, and get cooking, honey. Because it's just starting to get hot. You just need a little momentum. You just need a little push. That's all you need. And when I say you, I just really mean myself, by the way. Alright, thanks for sticking through that commercial break. Lo and behold, here is the reference photo that I have been using. I know you're probably thinking, Candace?
This is a strange photo to use. Why did you use this photo?
No, honestly, this wasn't supposed to be a serious painting. I mean, this isn't something I was gonna go full hands down and say, hey, this is gonna be a painting. No. I really just went for it, and I didn't give a crap, and I just took a random photo of myself in my studio, because you know what? I'm a painter, and I can do whatever I want.
Besides the fact that I went into this painting acknowledging that it was going to be purely based on a study, I also just chose this photo because it was a fresh photo. I didn't have any makeup on, I just threw my hair up, I rolled out of bed, and I said to myself, hey, you know what, I'm gonna paint today. And I'm gonna do it. I don't need to have makeup on, I don't need to be selfie ready, if you will. Also, so sorry, I'm pretty sure that I've said if you will in like every single video that I've made, so I'm so sorry. Also, if it sounded like I was being arrogant when I said that I am a painter and I can do whatever I want, I mean that more in a way of being able to reclaim a voice. The reason why I'm painting is because there's a message that I want to say. And that message is, this is who I am in my environment. This is who I am without the makeup, without the fancy clothes, even if I wore fancy clothes, but this is who I am. Even if my workspace is super messy and maybe questionably dirty. Just kidding, it's definitely not dirty. Well, maybe that dirty clothes hamper in the corner over there. Well, alrighty, now we can see what we're working with now. Not a lot of value checking in order to get it to the place that it is right now. That's really the important step in order to move on to the color. You still have to figure out what that value is. You also might be wondering what I'm going to do with the background, and really I'm just going to leave it as the way it is right now. I'm just tying in the background into the foreground and keeping it at that. I have a goal at keeping this a continuous thing for myself. I do want to continue with the self-portraits as I have been doing and keep up with this similar style that I got going on, but I am just keeping this at a steady for what it is. So here's the final piece. I am so happy to not only just be done with this and move on to the next painting, but just to show you that this is purely a step into the right direction. This is going to be a painting that I'm going to use as my stepping stone or my stair to get to the next stair. I am really happy with how this turned out. I hope you are too, but most importantly, when you're a painter, you need to check with yourself and make sure that it's resolved with yourself, most importantly, of course, because you're the artist and you're the one that needs to be happy here. And of course, it's always nice to make other people happy with your work, but at the end of the day, you're the one that has to live with your paintings, and so if you're able to be satiated with that composition, that painting that you're creating, that is the goal, that is the place that you want to be, honey, that is the place that you want to be. And don't let anybody else get in that way. With their own opinions. I mean, I know it's easy to get caught up in what other people say, but just don't do it. Well, that will conclude our video for today, but I had a great time making this painting. I hope that you also enjoyed it. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, honey. Help a sister out, because you know what? I know that you want to.